Will the verdict in the trial for George Floyd's murder tell the truth? Do we need a verdict to tell us a man was murdered? The defense attorney would have you believe George Floyd is responsible for his own death. They'll point to his health and narcotics found within his system and tell the grand jury that that, not Derek Chauvin, caused the death. The prosecution believes a knee in the neck while being subdued on the ground by several officers at once restricted his breathing. And the nail in the coffin was the knee itself. We saw the knee firmly planted and adjusted to dig in deeper. We saw a callous disregard for the pleas that he get off his neck. We saw the body go limp as all breath left and no attempt to revive him. Wouldn't there be at least an attempt upon seeing the victims unconscious? Wouldn't there be fear or dismay that perhaps he had killed him? But there was none of these, even as urine streamed from the body, indicating a loss of life had occurred. So at what point can we believe this was an accidental killing? What in the actions of these officers indicated they merely wanted to subdue him? Because once they had subdued him, they maintained the hold. They maintained the pressure, and the knee was dug in further into the neck. The 911 dispatcher who saw it became alarmed. According to her testimony, something was wrong because they were there on top of him too long. So much so, she thought a computer screen had frozen. She knew something had gone wrong because they requested no assistance or backup while maintaining their hold on this man. So clearly, they had him exactly where and how they wanted him. And they maintained that position until all the words stopped, along with his breathing. The insult to those who saw it and understood a murder was in progress for which they were powerless to prevent or interrupt is being made to watch a trial where they proceed to blame it on the victim in an attempt to excuse the guilty. And adding further insult is the fact the guilty himself acknowledged the crime committed when he pled guilty in his attempt to make a plea bargain deal, which was ultimately rejected no less than 3 days after the murder. But great fanfare and attention is being given as if his guilt is not already known. And every witness is being carefully scrutinized as if they'll reveal something we didn't already know. What we know is this. George Floyd was alive and well, despite whatever he may have had within his system, and his health did not interfere with his living. It was police who interfered with his living, and they would not relent until that life had ended. If there's no guilt here, and the blame is solely on the victims, and we are the cause for our own murders by police, then every officer entering our presence must be deemed a threat against our very life, which must be protected because the threat is real and no court of law will punish those police who take it. I'm Danette Chavis for National Action Against Police Brutality and Murder. Like us on Facebook and join with over 1 million and counting who are seeking police accountability by way of punishment across this nation. I hope you'll support us by way of donating and pass the demand on. Help galvanize a nationwide movement for police accountability across the board. Thank you.